Welcome, my name is Carrie, and at our house, all the windows have screens except two, the window to the kitchen and a window in the basement. I'm going to try building new screens myself and hopefully save a little money. I'll start first at the window to the kitchen. This window is a bit different from other windows I've added screens to in that in the channel for the screen, there are rubber spacers on the sides of the screen channel and a spacer in the bottom channel. The rubber spacers sit below the lip of each channel about an eighth of an inch. These spacers will prevent the new screen from going too deep into the channels. To begin, I'll take a tape measure and put the end of the tape at the very top of the upper channel, then measure down to the top edge of the bottom channel. My measurement is 33 1/4 inches. I get this measurement on the other side of the window also. When I cut my new frame to length, I want it to be a 1/16 to 1/8 inch shorter than this measurement. That way I won't have trouble getting the new screen into the channel in the window frame. Next, I'll take a side-to-side measurement on the window. My measurement is 29 3/8 inches. To this measurement, I want to add 1/8 inch so that the screen will sit just inside the channel edges on the sides of the screen. The next step is to measure the channel width for the screen. My measurement is 3/8 inch, so when I buy screen frames, I'll buy the next possible size down, which is 5/16 inch. Everything I've read on screens recommends going to the next size down after finding the channel width. These are screen kits that I bought at Home Depot for $10 each. Each is a 5/16 screen kit with 4 frame pieces that are 36 inches long. Each kit comes with spline in the frames, 4 corner connectors, tension springs, and 2 pull tabs. I also bought a spline roller for $3 and some fiberglass screen material that is charcoal in color for $7. First, I'll take one of the frame pieces and cut it to length. My original measurement was 33 1/4 inches, and if I subtract 1/8 inch from that, that leaves me 33 1/8 inches. The corner piece also requires that I subtract another 1.5 inches from that total. So my final measurement for 2 of the frame pieces is 31 5/8 inches. Once I get the 2 pieces measured and cut, I'll move on to the side pieces. Here my original measurement was 29 1/4 inches, and in this case I want to add 1/8 inch to each side, which brings the total to 29 1/2 inches. After subtracting 1.5 inches for the corner pieces, my new total will be 28 inches for the 2 side frame pieces. When these 2 pieces are cut, I'll take a flat file and remove the burrs from the cuts, then take a corner connector for each corner and begin assembling the frame. The top of the screen gets a tension spring at each corner. With the frame assembled, I'll remove the spline from the grooves in the 4 frame pieces, then I'll take some duct tape and tape down the frame. The duct tape will keep the frame from bowing when I roll in the spline. Next, I'll insert the 2 pull tabs into the groove on the end opposite from the tension springs. Then I'll take the screen cloth, roll it over the frame, and cut it with a pair of scissors. Then I'll take a piece of spline, push it into the groove in the frame, and start rolling towards the next corner. According to the spline roller instructions, I should use the convex wheel on the roller to push the spline into the groove, then use the concave part of the roller a second time to go over the spline again. When I get to a corner, I'll push the spline in with a screwdriver as I round the corner, then continue down the next side. After I get 2 sides done, I'll start putting a bit of sideways pressure on the screen as I roll in the spline on the third side, and a bit of side pressure on the screen as I roll in the fourth side. Careful when you do this, too much side pressure on the screen will tear it when you roll the spline in. After the four sides are done, I'll go around the frame one more time with the concave wheel on the spline roller to make sure the spline is seated nicely into the groove on the frame. With the spline installed, I'll take a utility knife and trim the excess screen from the frame. I want the knife on a 45 degree angle, and I want it to ride just above the spline as I trim the excess screen away. After trimming the screen, I'll remove the duct tape from the frame, then take the new screen and see how it fits into the window. To install the screen, I want to slide one corner of the screen into the channel just above the top spacer. Once I get both top corners into the channel, I'll lift up on the pull tabs until the bottom edge of the screen clears the lip on the channel. Once in place, the tension springs at the top of the screen frame will keep constant down pressure on the screen, which will hold it securely in place. Okay, one window down and one to go. On this basement window, the deepest part of the channel is on the right side. This is where the tension clips will need to go. On the second screen kit I bought, it looks like one frame piece will be long enough to build two sides of the screen. After measuring for the screen dimensions, I'm ready to cut the frames. What I'll do that's a little bit different on this screen is remove the spline before I cut the frame pieces. Then I'll have longer lengths of spline to roll into the groove. Here, the process is the same as the first screen. I need to cut the frame pieces, install the corner connectors, the tension springs, and the pull tabs. When the frame is built, I'll roll the spline into the grooves, and when I reach the third and fourth sides of rolling the spline in, I'll put just a bit of side pressure on the screen to make it tighter. When the spline is installed, I'll trim the excess screen with a utility knife, then remove the duct tape. Like the last screen, I want the end with the tension clips to go into the channel first, then compress the clips until I get the opposite end of the screen into the channel. So that completes this video on building window screens. For around $30, I was able to buy the materials needed to build two window screens and have enough materials left over to build one more smaller screen. If you like the video, please click the thumbs up, and to see more of my how-to videos, visit my channel iScaper1 on YouTube.